It's a lot here.
Haters are hating on my girl Cardi B because she has that mixed girl magic. She has that beautiful hair that everybody's trying to emulate. There's nobody out here blackfishing. There's nobody out here really whitefishing at this point. It's just pretty much a whole bunch of mixed fishing. Well, actually, there is some whitefishing. The chicks who wear that blonde hair looking ridiculous. Looking like Duracell batteries and members of the Wu-Tang Clan. Black and yellow, looking like they're about to sing a Wiz Khalifa song. But let me go ahead and read to what your girl Cardi B with her beautiful self had to say on Twitter about people hating.
So I've been consistent with my hair mask routine and drinking alkaline water, and look how much my hair has grown. I was so scared of my hair falling out after my son's birth because I've been growing it for years now. So I made sure to keep up with it, and I actually gained hair.
Wish I could gain some inches down here, but anyways, that's none of y'all's business. So a fan said on Twitter, Freudian slip, that's literally her genetics, not a hair mask, girl. And my girl Cardi B said,
it's genetics. No, it's proper hair maintenance. I have a hair texture that requires lots of love and maintenance. These pictures show my hair from childhood, high school, and adulthood. And since I started taking care of my hair the right way, it has grown tremendously.
Then Cardi B didn't stop there. She posted 4 pictures on Twitter. Then she posted even more. She posted, I don't know, 8, 9, 10 different pictures and videos total up on Instagram. And here's what she said on there.
Why every time I post my natural hair, I hear, you're mixed. You're supposed to have long hair. That's not true and very misleading. I've been posting pictures of my hair journey for years, and being mixed don't mean your hair is always long and curly. That wasn't my case. Since I was a child, I had problems with managing my hair, and a couple of years ago, I found different methods that work for me, and look at my length now. They'll try to make us believe our hair won't grow this long. It's not true. A lot of hair products we used back then wasn't good for our hair. But that's all we had to choose from. Also, we couldn't afford to get to the salon regularly, if at all. Now everybody is getting better options, making affordable, good products, learning from natural hair, YouTube, and TikTok about how to care for our hair better. I want women of color with tighter curl patterns to know that you don't have bad hair. There's no such thing as bad hair, and quote-unquote good hair don't mean a certain texture. All hair is good hair. Check out my pinned story here, Dave. And I can't wait to show you more of my hair care routines.
Telling a chick who has the mixed fish by making her hair, quote, baby hairs, which is just trying to look like a mixed girl because that's not what your edges look like. When your edges look like taco meat, why try to make them look like rainbows? Here's the thing, right? So Cardi B is basically doing this whole, you know, like all hair is good hair, all hair matters, foolishness. That's a lie. Now, all hair is not good hair. Bad hair, listen. People always ask me, you always use this term good hair. What does that mean? And like I have to tell people, good hair is hair that you're willing to pay for. Hair is the hair you're trying to imitate. Good hair is the hair that people cut off and sell, and it sells, well, I would say around the world, but it really sells here in America because, you know, certain people have to buy it, so then that way they can have good hair too, even though it's not really theirs. Telling Miss Lint Filter over here that she has good hair when she has to go through all of these processes of chemically dealing with her hair, you know, putting stuff on her hair that could kill a person, stuff that you can't ingest, stuff that may or may not contain carcinogens, stuff that may seep into your skull and leave a green sludge on your brain, allegedly, possibly, maybe. When you're dealing with stuff like that and you have to wear gloves to put products on your hair because your hair is that untamed and you have to whip it that bad, you have to slave over your hair just to make it work. Telling somebody with bad hair that they have good hair and that all hair matters and that all hair is good hair is like stepping on a roach and saying all lives matter. You don't really mean it, but you're saying it because you think that it sounds good and it will help somebody feel more emotionally balanced, and it will keep you from ruining their day by telling them the truth. But that's what I'm here to do, piss on people's parades, okay? And a lot of people do have bad hair. This whole thing about all hair is good hair is not true. And I'm going to tell you who has the best hair in the world, other than, of course, Asian women who have, like, you know, the pinnacle of good hair. And that's mixed women. Mixed women have the best hair, okay? Including Cardi B, who's a mixed woman, okay? So I just told y'all the truth, okay? And like I told y'all before, okay? I told this joke before, and I told a couple times recently. I liken hair to the story of Goldilocks and the Three Bears, okay? There's black hair, there's white hair, and there's mixed hair, right? And I include, I guess, Asian hair in like the mixed hair category because it looks the same when mixed girls straighten their hair. But it's like the story of Goldilocks and Three Bears, okay? So black hair is too hot, white hair is too cold, mixed hair is just right. Just like that bed in the Goldilocks and Three Bears story or the porridge. It's the same thing. You know, once you have that balance of hot and cold, it becomes perfect. That's how you get perfection, okay? It's alchemy. Listen, y'all, I got to go because some of y'all are so sensitive about this topic about hair. And it's like, listen, if you don't have good hair, you don't have good hair. You know, everybody is not a mixed girl. So we don't have good hair, good genes, and we don't look beautiful like mixed women do. But anyways, click the thumbs up button, subscribe, choose all notifications. Let me know you listen all the way to the end of this video. The secret password to say in the comment section is, here we go again. But it's hair, H-A-I-R, like the hair on your head. That's if you have any, because I know that some people have a sizzling snatch of burnt popcorn nestled upon the top of their knobby noggin. You know, some people got an elbow head and a little bit of elbow grease. You know, they're walking around with damn bird's nest on top of that elbow head. And that bothers some people out here. And I'm not naming names. I'm just speaking in general here. But anyways, let me know what you guys think about it below. The links to my other two channels are in the description box. Make sure you click the thumbs up button, subscribe, and choose all notifications. What do you guys think? Do you think that I'm tripping here? Or do you know that I'm telling the truth? Y'all want to know what good hair is? Good hair is hair that you pay for. Any other hair that people won't pay for? Whatever is the least sold type of hair has to be bad hair. Because whatever that looks like must not be anything that anybody wants. It just doesn't have value. It's like, come on now, do you want to look like a clown or a beauty queen? You know, and shout out to Young Hollywood because he had told Amara La Negra the truth on Love & Hip Hop, and that truth bothered a lot of people, and a lot of people were like, hey, you know, I don't want to hear all this truth shit, you know, just don't be out here telling me, you know, that I can't wear my hair a certain way and shit. And it's like, man, shut the hell up. Put the comb to your dome or take your ass home.